抓到让你吉祥的显现日，我非常荣幸地邀请到了圣巴比维纳维纳什纳西纳斯瓦米马哈拉什给我们讲解今天的导课，敬请聆听。哈瑞克什纳，
哈瑞克什纳，Om Magyana Tamarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militanena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namam Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Tapta Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Bhavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namah Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadhi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So as Guru Mani Mataji said, today is the auspicious day of Radhastami. Srimati Radharani appears in this world 14 days after the appearance of Lord Krishna. Srimati Radharani appears in the family of Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Kirtida, and they live their home, they have a palace in Varsana.
Srimati Radharani appears in Vrishabhanu Wang, Kirtida, Mama's house.
So it is said when Srimati Radharani appeared, her eyes were closed and her parents were anxious that this is unusual, that my child hasn't opened her eyes yet.
Srimati Radharani 显现的时候呢, 她的双眼是紧闭着的，她的父母感到非常担心，我们这个孩子有一点异常，她的眼睛不睁开。
So it happened that Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj heard how Kirtida and Vrishabhanu had a daughter. So they came along with their child, they brought Lord Krishna with them. They came to Varsana to see the child of Vrishabhanu and Kirtida, and they brought Lord Krishna with them. And Lord Krishna was crawling on the ground, and he crawled in front of the cot where Srimati Radharani was as a small baby. And as soon as Lord Krishna came in front of Srimati Radharani, then immediately she opened her eyes. So the first person she saw with her eyes was Lord Krishna.
Krishna 就在地上爬行，当他爬到了Srimati Radharani的这个女婴睡着的小摇篮的时候，他就来到了他的面前。 这时候，这个小女婴就睁开了眼睛，所以是 Srimati Radharani 她在见到的、亲眼见到的第一个人是 Krishna。
Actually, Srimati Radharani only has eyes for Krishna. She does not see any other man. She only sees Lord Krishna.
事实上 ，Srimati Radharani 的眼睛。只是为了看 Krishna 的，他的眼睛不会落向任何一个男人身上。
So Srimati Radharani is the non-different from Lord Krishna. She is the pleasure potency of Lord Krishna. She is described as the Ladini Shakti.
Srimati Radharani, 她跟 Krishna 没有不同，她是 Krishna 的快乐能量，她被称为是 Ladini Shakti。
Lord Krishna possesses three internal potencies. One is the Ladini Shakti, which is for his pleasure.
Krishna 有三个内在能量。其中之一是 Ladini Shakti， 是为了他的快乐存在的能量。
Another potency is the Sandini Shakti. Sandini Shakti is his existential potency by which he maintains the whole spiritual creation.
在这三个能量当中，还有一个是 Sandini。
All of the different bodies of Krishna's devotees in the spiritual world, they're all there due to they're all the creations of the Sandini Shakti, Krishna's existential potency.And the third potency is the Sambit Shakti, or the cognitive potency, by which Krishna reveals knowledge of himself to the living entities.
The third potency is the Sambit Shakti.是 Krishna 认知能量，它是指 Krishna 把自己揭示给众生的能量。
So Srimati Radharani personifies this pleasure potency of Lord Krishna, that she gives the greatest pleasure to Lord Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 是指 Krishna 的快乐能量的化身，它给予 Krishna。
And just as Lord Krishna has many expansions and avatars which all come from him, so Srimati Radharani also expands herself in different ways. All of the consorts of Lord Krishna are expansions of Srimati Radharani. The consorts of Lord Krishna are the goddesses of fortune, and Lord Krishna's wives in Dwarka, and the gopis in Braja.So Srimati Radharani, She gives the greatest pleasure to Krishna because one reason is she's the most attractive, she's the most beautiful of all the consorts of Lord Krishna. She has the most wonderful qualities of all the consorts, and she has the greatest love for Krishna. There are different pastimes which Lord Krishna performs, which reveal the deep love which Srimati Radharani has for Lord Krishna. One pastime takes place during Rasa Lila. Now Krishna, during Rasa Lila, he would dance with all the gopis. In fact, he would have two gopis, one gopi on the left side, one gopi on the right side. So Krishna was dancing Rasa Lila like this, but with Srimati Radharani, he would just dance with her. He would have only one, only Radharani was with him, no other gopi. With the other gopis, there were two gopis with him. But with Srimati Radharani, he was alone with her. In this way, he gave her special prominence. So while Krishna was dancing the Rasa Lila, at one point he disappeared from the Rasa Lila. He just disappeared, and all the gopis were anxious. Where is Krishna gone? And they went to look for him.
Krishna
So they were looking, and finally, after a long time, they were looking. They saw the footprints of Lord Krishna. They could identify Lord Krishna's footprints because of the very unique markings on the sole of his feet. So then they looked more, as they followed the footprints, they saw there was another pair of footprints. They saw that somebody was with Lord Krishna, and they could understand that these were the footprints of a woman, a young woman. And they understood, oh, this woman, she must be very special to Lord Krishna. That Lord Krishna has some special affection for this one girl, that he's taken her away from all of us just so he can be with her on his own. Who is this fortunate girl? So as they searched, they saw there was at one point they saw how Lord Krishna's footprints, he'd stood on his tiptoes and he'd stretched up to pick some flowers from the trees. And the gopis understood that, oh, this is where Krishna picked flowers and he's going to put them in the hair of this gopi who is with him. So all the gopis were thinking how fortunate this other gopi is, that she's that Lord Krishna is so attracted to her, that he takes so much care of her. So it said at one point, the gopi who is with Krishna, this is of course Srimati Radharani, and she says to Krishna that, oh, I cannot walk anymore, you will have to carry me, you can take me wherever you want. So while they were talking to Uddhava, the gopis, the gopis are very simple young girls, and they surrounded Uddhava, and they were talking with him. At that point, then Srimati Radharani was there, and a bumblebee appeared, and it began to go towards her feet. And so Srimati Radharani then began to address this bumblebee, and she would talk to the bumblebee that it was a messenger from Lord Krishna. And she began to speak to this bumblebee, and she was speaking to the bumblebee just like it was a person who was a servant of Krishna. And this was Srimati Radharani in her ecstasy, talking to the bumblebee. So she's saying to the bumblebee, Oh, you've sent, no, that you're the servant of Lord Krishna. So Lord Krishna has sent you here to see his mother and father, because Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda are there in Vrindavan. So Lord Krishna is concerned for his family. So he sent you here to find out about his family. And Radharani then said to the bumblebee, I know you only care about your family members. You only care about the family of Lord Krishna. You don't care about any of his friends. You are the servant of Lord Krishna, but your Lord Krishna is an unreliable master, and you are the unreliable servant of an unreliable master. Srimati Radharani went on to give examples. He said, I know your nature. Just like you go to flowers and you take honey, you take the honey from them, then you leave them, you never go back.
Srimati Radharani 进花之后，就到另一朵鲜花那里去采新鲜的花蜜，然后你就再也永远不回来了。Then
Srimati Radharani went on to give more examples. She said, just like a student, so long as he's getting education, he's interested in his school and his teachers. But once his education is completed, he goes from the school and he never worries anymore about the teachers or the school. Or just like the birds have interest in the fruit trees, so long as they're fruit. But once the fruit season is over, they have no more interest in that tree. So in this way, Srimati Radharani gave many examples describing this nature of which people have. They will, so long as they can get some benefit from someone, they are interested in them. But as soon as there's no more benefit, then they give them up. Then Srimati Radharani went on to describe Lord Krishna in a very critical way. She spoke about him being cruel and hard-hearted, and she gave examples.
Srimati Radharani 进一步描述了 Krishna， 他变得对 Krishna 有一点批评的口吻。他说 Krishna 很残忍，他内心特别的残忍。他又举了一些例子。
He said, just like Lord Krishna allowed us to taste the nectar from his lips one time, but now he's gone away and left us. He's gone to Mathura to live in the city. He doesn't care about us and the village women. He doesn't care about our cows and our pastures here. He's gone to the city. Srimati Radharani said, we have heard all about Lord Krishna from Purnamasi. She told us about what he was like, about how he's cruel and hard-hearted. She told us about his past life. In his past life, he was called Ramachandra.
Purnamasi 向我们描述的主 Krishna 的前世，他的前世，他是主 Ramachandra。
So as Ramachandra, he was born in the family of a king. He was a Kshatriya. But when he fought against Vali, that he hid behind a tree and then fired arrows into Vali. He didn't fight him like a real Kshatriya. He didn't stand in front of him and fight. He stood behind the tree and then fired arrows into the chest of Vali and killed him. A Kshatriya is supposed to stand in front and they're supposed to fight on equal terms. But Ramachandra used this trick. He used a tricking manner to kill Vali. And then he was approached by Surpanaka, and Surpanaka was attracted to have an amorous relationship with Lord Ramachandra. And as a Kshatriya, he should have accepted her and he should have satisfied her.
Suparnika 想跟 Ramachandra 有一段爱恋之情，建立一种爱恋的关系。可是作为 Kshatriya， Ramachandra 不应该接受这位 女人而满足她。
But because Ramachandra was so attached to his wife Sita Devi, he wouldn't touch Surpanika. He refused her. And not only did he refuse her, he cut off her nose and ears and disfigured her. You see how he's so henpecked, he's so attached to his wife Sita Devi, he did like this to this poor woman, Surpanika. And then another incident which happened was in his previous life before Ramachandra, he was a Brahmana and he came and he begged charity from Bali Maharaj. And Bali Maharaj gave him everything he had. He gave him his whole kingdom, everything. And what did he do? That he tied him up with ropes. And he sent him down to Patala Loka, one of the lower planets in the lower region of the universe. Yeah, Patala Loka, one of the planets in the bottom of the universe.
Patala Loka is in the universe, one of the planets in the bottom of the
universe. So just see how cruel and hard-hearted this Lord Krishna is. So while Radharani was talking in this way to the bumblebee, and she's saying to the bumblebee, don't touch me. I know you're just trying to come, you just want to make a show of affection for me, and you want me to forgive you. But don't touch me. I don't want anything more to do with you.
Srimati Radharani 这样对大黄蜂说话，她对他说，别碰我。
Yeah, the bee was going to Radharani's lotus feet, and you know, it's like an expression of humility. But Srimati Radharani was rebuked, saying, no, you don't touch me, don't come near me.
这只黄蜂呢，它飞向Radharani的莲花族，像是一种谦卑的姿态，可是却被Radharani一口拒绝了。Radharani对他说：“不，你不要接近我，不要碰我。”Srimati
Radharani said to the bee that, although it's a we. Although you have given us so much pain, the problem is we cannot give up talking about you. Although you're so cruel and hard-hearted, but still we cannot give up ever. We always talk about you and remember you. We cannot give up thinking about you.
And
even great saints and sages who have given up everything in the material world, they also cannot give up talking about you and remembering all of your activities and pastimes. So then suddenly the bumblebee disappeared.
And then Srimati Radharani became very worried. She became almost mad in anxiety. And she thought, oh, maybe the bee is gone to tell Krishna everything I said about him. And when Krishna hears all the things I've said about him, he'll feel very sad.
突然之间狂风消失了，Srimati Radharani一下子担心起来，她一进疯狂，她说：“哦，也许这只是蜜蜂，去向主Krishna汇报我的说的一切。向主Krishna听了我的话，他一定会感到内心非常难过的。”
But then suddenly the bumblebee reappeared, and then Srimati Radharani felt so much relief, and she said, oh, again you have come. How is Lord Krishna? Is he asking about us? Have you come to take me to him? But how will you take me to him? How can you ever carry me there? You're so small, and you can never carry me there. Anyway, how is Lord Krishna? Tell me. In this way, Radharani was addressing the bumblebee in her ecstasy of love of Krishna.
但是突然之间大黄蜂又重新出现了。Radharani突然之间大黄蜂出现了，Radharani感到松了一口气，他就对他说：“哦，你又来了。” Krishna 怎样了？他是不是在询问我们？你是不是要把我带去见他呢？可是你怎么带我去见他呢？你这么小，你怎么能带我去见主 Krishna？ Krishna 怎么样了？快告诉我他的消息。所以 Radharani 不这样，以狂喜的口吻开始说话。
So in this way, Uddhava was hearing how the gopis, and particularly Srimati Radharani, how they had so much deep love and affection for Lord Krishna. And some people even say that Lord Krishna personally took the form of the bumblebee to come and buzz around Srimati Radharani just so he could hear all of her ecstatic talking.
有的人说，这只大黄蜂就是主Krishna亲自变成了这只大黄蜂，化身而来，来聆听Krishna，聆听Radharani。
So we understand that when Lord Krishna appeared, he had three desires which he was not able to fulfill. First of all, he wanted to experience the love, just like Srimati Radharani has so much love for Lord Krishna. Now, Lord Krishna likes pleasure, but he saw that the pleasure which Srimati Radharani gets is a million times greater than his pleasure, and he wants to experience that pleasure.
第一个愿望是Krishna他希望来体验爱，因为 Radharani 对 Krishna 有这么多的爱，Krishna 他也喜欢快乐，但是 Radharani 体验到的快乐要比 Krishna 感受到的快乐高100万倍，所以主 Krishna 想体验到这种快乐。The
second desire was that Krishna has wonderful qualities. And these qualities, they attract even Krishna, but they give the greatest pleasure to Srimati Radharani. When Radharani sees these wonderful qualities in Krishna, She feels so much bliss.
第二个, Krishna, 他仍然没有得到满足的愿望, 就是, 因为去感受, 主 Krishna 的美好品质, 主 Krishna 的这些美好品质, 甚至吸引了他本人, 就最能给人带来最大的快乐, 就, 主 Krishna 这些品质, 他使人感受到,
And the third desire was that when Radharani sees the love which Krishna has for her, it gives her the greatest pleasure. The deep love which Krishna has for Radharani gives Radharani the greatest pleasure.
Krishna 对 Radharani 的深深的爱意，就给 Radharani 带来了最深沉的、最了不起的快乐。
So Krishna wanted to fulfill these three desires, and he couldn't do it as Lord Krishna. Therefore, he came in the Kali Yuga as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to experience the mood of Srimati Radharani.
所以他希望满足他这个三个心愿，可是做在主Krishna的这个身份里呢，他是没办法实现这三个心愿了，他就以主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的身份来降临，只是为了体验Srimati Radharani的心态。Yes,
so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the embodiment of Srimati Radharani. He is Radha Bhava Murti. He is a form of the sentiment of Radharani. He is Krishna, but he is in the mood of Srimati Radharani. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not only has the sentiment of Radharani, but he also comes with the complexion of Srimati Radharani, which is the golden color.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 不仅拥有 Radharani 的强烈的情感, 他还有 Radharani 的金黄的肤色。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes in the mood of the devotee.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是以奉献者的心绪心态来降临于世的。
Lord Krishna is the predominator of all. And the gopis and Srimati Radharani, they are predominated by Lord Krishna. And as they predominated, the gopis like Srimati Radharani, they want to give pleasure to Krishna. And when they give pleasure to Krishna, it gives them the greatest happiness. So we see this mood in Lord Chaitanya's Shikshastikam prayers, in the final verse of the Shikshastikam, he's expressing the mood of Srimati Radharani. When he says that if my being unhappy makes you happy, then that is my happiness. So this is the nature of pure, unselfish love, that we don't think of our own happiness, we think of others' happiness. This is the mood of the gopis, and this is the mood of Srimati Radharani in their service to Lord Krishna. And this loving mood, this is performed on the level of raga bhakti. This is the mood of spontaneous devotion for Lord Krishna. And this kind of devotion is seen only in Vrindavan, among the people in Braja. And of all the people in Braja, the greatest devotees are the gopis. And of all the gopis, the greatest devotee is Srimati Radharani.
这种自发的父爱可以在文达文的居民身上，在布拉扎巴西身上找到。在他们当中，这些牧牛姑娘是最了不起的奉献者。在所有牧牛姑娘当中，Srimati Radharani是佼佼者。So
all the people in Vrindavan, they all want to get the blessings of Srimati Radharani, and they will pray to Srimati Radharani to please bless us, because if Srimati Radharani will give her blessings, then certainly Lord Krishna will accept. We want to give something to Krishna. If it comes through Radharani, then certainly Lord Krishna will accept. Haribo? Gurumani? Gurumani, Hare Krishna. Gurumani.
Hare Krishna, can you hear me?
Yeah, now I'm back. Yeah, I got disconnected.
Oh, sorry.
Because, Mayapur. Okay, so I was saying, if Radharani will offer something to Krishna, then certainly Krishna will accept it.
如果Srimati Radharani把供奉献给Krishna的话，那Krishna一定会接受这份供奉的。
So we are all praying to Srimati Radharani to give her mercy on us on this very special day when she appeared in this world. We have to also pray to Srimati Radharani for her mercy, that somehow we can also develop some devotion and love for Lord Krishna. There is another verse which is also spoken by Srimati Radharani, which is a very important verse, and it was uttered at the time of leaving the body by a great devotee named Madhavendra Puri. Ai dina dayadra natha he matura natha nalakalo vashe. This verse is saying that, where are you now, O master of Mathura? Because of my not seeing you, my most agitated heart has become unstable. What should I do now? So this verse was uttered by Madhavendra Puri, and it said this verse is only understood by three devotees: Madhavendra Puri, Srimati Radharani, and Lord Chaitanya. This verse describes the feeling of the separation which the gopis felt from Krishna. So, Lord Chaitanya came to experience this mood of the gopis. The mood of the gopis is service in separation. We want to also cultivate the mood. Prabhupada encouraged us that we should do service in separation. We should not think, I am seeing Krishna, but we should think, when is Krishna going to come to see us? So Srimati Radharani is just like a young girl. Her body is not material, it's fully spiritual. Just like Lord Krishna has a spiritual body, Srimati Radharani also has a spiritual body. In the material world, the love of the material world is just sense gratification. It's all based on the material body, and it is not pure. It is very selfish business of satisfying our senses. But in the spiritual world, in the dealings between Radha and Krishna, it is completely pure and spiritual. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore wanted to also experience this mode of giving pleasure to Krishna. Although he is Krishna himself, he comes to experience the mood of the devotee, because that is the greatest happiness. All right, so we'll stop here. We'll take a few questions, but at 6 o'clock, at 8:30, I have to go.
Thank you, Guru Maharaj. Previously, in previous age, people used to worship only Krishna alone. When do people begin to worship Krishna along with Radharani? From which acharya they began to introduce the worship to this divine couple?
Well, Lord Chaitanya introduced it. Lord Chaitanya explained it, and then the followers of Lord Chaitanya, they would worship. And it was Lord Nityananda's wife, Janavi, that many times she would add the deity of Radharani beside the deity of Krishna. Yeah, she would arrange that because they just have the deity of Krishna, so she would want to add the deity of Radharani alongside Krishna.
So
it really started from the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But the other sampradaya, we see also Nimbarka sampradaya, they also worship Radha and Krishna.
In other sampradaya, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, and devotees, please accept my humble obeisance. It's very difficult to understand how we can have a proper relationship with Krishna to know if he is satisfied with our service. How can Srimati Radharani help us? Yina, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 就是很难就要理解我们跟 Krishna 之间 如何拥有一种恰当的关系，这很难，并且知道 Krishna 对我们的服务满意不满意也不太容易。那Radharani在这方面怎么可以帮助到我们呢？帮助到我们理解我们和 Krishna 恰当的关系和我们对 Krishna 的服务是否满意。Well,
you have to take instruction from your spiritual master. You have to be guided by the spiritual teachers. They will instruct you how to please Krishna.
需要得到你的灵性导师的训示，那些灵性导师们可以指导你如何做到这一点。Go
ahead.
第三个 乌什顶拜咕噜响顶咕噜，请问咕噜今天如何祈祷才是卑微表达，并让喇嘀尼听到我们想表达的福？ So today, how can we pray? What prayer is very humble expression so that Radharani can hear our words, hear our expression about our service?
We chant the Maha Mantra. That's the best.
最好的又是唱诵 Maha Mantra 了。The
gopis also chant the holy name. They also chant the holy name of Krishna.
就是我们始终都是在唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名。下一个把它唱，Krishna的顶拜咕噜，请问 Radharani和唐方风的倾诉对 Krishna的责备是否会引起大家误解，还是这的确是 Krishna本性的一方面？So the Radharani talking with the humble bee. Radharani began to criticize Krishna. Will that cause misunderstanding of everyone, or is it really the nature of Krishna?
Well, it was the ecstasy of Radharani. It was ecstasy. Sometimes when one is in ecstasy, one will talk like that, one will say things which are critical, but at the same time, it's a glorification of Krishna.
This month we have honored several big festivals. As devotional students, we want to make spiritual progress. Our procedure of prayer, offering prayer, should we first worship Lord Nityananda or worship Radharani or our Diksha Guru or directly offer prayer to Lord Krishna?
Usually the procedure is we go through the spiritual master, and from the spiritual master you can go to Lord Nityananda. And then from Lord Nityananda you can go to Lord Chaitanya. And from Lord Chaitanya, you can go to Radha and Krishna.
Mm-hmm. 祈祷的程序是这么个祈祷顺序，我们首先向我们自己的灵性导师献上祈祷，然后呢向主尼加南的祈祷，之后呢一步又向主泰丹念马哈帕布祈祷，然后进一步向 Radha Krishna 献上祈祷。那下一个分身 Hare Krishna， 我可以理解为 Krishna 在另一个时空，我只能看见他的物质能量，看不见他本人，但是我说什么做什么他知道，他看得见吗？ Hare Krishna， obeisance to all devotees， can I understanding that Krishna is situated in another category, in anotherdegree of time and space. I can only see his material energy now. I cannot see him personally. But whatever I see, whatever I do, he will know. Can he hear whatever I say and know whatever I do and see?
Yes, of course Krishna knows whatever you say and whatever you do.
Krishna 当然知道你说的话，知道你做的事情了。
Krishna is everywhere and he knows everything. As a super soul, he's everywhere and he knows everything.
作为超灵， Krishna 无处不在，他无所不知。Next,
yeah.
下一个 Vivo 有三 Radharani 是主的内在喜乐能量，是主慧能的扩展。主是为了让我们学习如何崇拜爱主，从而让我们找到自己的地位。Oh, this is a comment.
Okay.
下一个问题 ，Harvamsa， 是呢？八岁离开文大文，是不是 Krishna 与 Gopi 的消失光就是八岁？一些 Gopi 的年龄段有八岁，也有婚后的二三十岁的吗？ Krishna left Vrindavan when he is 8 years old. Is that a Krishna's pastime with Gopi is when Krishna is 6 years old? And what's the age of this Gopi? Are there also 8 years old, or are there any gopi who is in their 20 and 30 years old?
There are older gopis. Yes, there are older gopis. There are young gopi girls and there are older gopis. The older gopis, the married ladies with their families, and the younger gopis, not yet married. There are many different ages of gopis.
有年纪大的勾比牧牛姑娘，她们是已婚的，还有年轻的牧牛姑娘，她们是未婚的，所以牧牛姑娘有不同的年龄段都有。下一个 Sitarani 顶拜姑，早上亚洲的小朋友荣耀怕可杀的时问妈妈，你们为什么一过节就过就戒食啊？怎么回答呢？我们戒食的心态是什么呢？In the early morning, when Yashoda, little Yashoda on the prasada, she asked, Mother, why you are always fasting when there's a festival? How can I answer her question? What's the mood of our fast?
Well, we're fasting. Usually, like today, Radharani is very merciful. It's just a half day fast. We just don't take any breakfast. But at midday, there should be a nice feast.
今天 Radharani 特别仁慈，我们戒食半天就好了，就是我们只是错过了一顿早餐而已，可是到了中午的时候我们可以荣耀一个大餐，美妙的大餐了。
So the mood of the festival is that we're doing this as out of respect for the great personality who appears on this particular day.
心态是我们尊敬，我们向那些就是在这个特殊的日子显现的伟大人物们致以我们的敬意。
And we pray for their blessings in our devotional service.
我们在我们各自的奉爱服务当中祈求得到他们的祝福。
Yogita
Sharma Hare Krishna Gurudev Panho. I'm having a feeling of some satisfaction while serving my deities of Trishi Radhe Shyam Sundar. Is it I shouldn't have such a small feeling of satisfaction? Not complete, but small feeling of satisfaction. Yogita Sharma 说，我服务我的 Shyam Sundar Radhe Shyam Sundar 的时候，我有一点小小的自满情绪。我是不是我不应该有这种小小的自满情绪呢？
No, you should have feeling of satisfaction. There's nothing wrong with that. Just like in separation from Krishna, there has to also be union with Krishna. There has to be coming together with Krishna. It's not always separation. There should be a time when we come together to be with Krishna.
是这样的。是你也可以有这种比较心满意足的这种情绪，这种没有错误，不像有跟 Krishna 的分离之情，也有跟 Krishna 相聚的这种感受，所以不是分离的，也有这种相，也有跟 Krishna 聚合在一起的时间。My guru 昨天用给 Radha。今天用给 Radha 单独崇拜，比如 RT。Shall we separately offer RT to Radha today? For example, RT?
No. No need. Just keep the same the way you do it regularly. You don't separate.
She need not to offer RT.Separated today to rather than today?
Yeah, you don't do that.
Oh, 不需要，今天不需要给 rather than 你单独供奉 RT. Ratna, 下一个 Ratna Mala, 明白姑妈 Raja, 请问 rather than 的身体是完全灵性的，为什么还有愤怒呢？是在演给我们看吗？ Krishna 的邪恶能量， Krishna 怎么体会不到呢？本来就拥有的东西应该体会到有点迷惑，你不觉得 ？Since Radharani's body is completely spiritual, why she has the mood, a hungry mood, is it to show to us?
It's for the pleasure of Krishna.
也是为了 Krishna, Radharani 的愤怒也是为了 Krishna 的快乐。
Yeah, because it increases Krishna's love for Radharani. He gets more pleasure like this. When he sees Radharani become a little angry, then he becomes more anxious for her.
This is for increasing Radharani's love. When Radharani gets a little angry,So this is to increase the anxious of Radharani.
Increase Krishna becomes more anxious for Radharani. Krishna's comes to look for her.
Okay.
Everything the gopis do, everything Srimati Radharani does is for the pleasure of Krishna. Radha and Krishna are originally one, but they separated themselves eternally.
Radha and Krishna 原本是一个但是他们是永恒的分开着的。
And so the whole mood, everything which Srimati Radharani does is just arrangements for the pleasure of Krishna and to increase their loving dealings, to give them more pleasure.
So, Ladini Shakti is Krishna's own pleasure potency. But why can't Krishna experience his own energy? Because he has already owned his own energy.
Well, it's his own energy, but he's manifested it in the form of Srimati Radharani.
没错，这是他的能量，但是他把这个能量改制为Srimati Radharani。
Everything is personal.
一切都是有人格的。
So it gives him more pleasure in this way.
这样就能给予更大的快乐，更多的快乐。 Sometimes Krishna wants to see Radharani, but Radharani is angry in a hungry mood and does not want to see the Lord. So the gopis, they don't allow the Lord to see them, and even drove
her away. Why disobey the instruction of the Lord? Yeah, this is Leela. This is for the pleasure of Radha and Krishna. That when they finally do meet, then it's so much pleasure. Of anxiety. There's anxiety, oh, I can't meet her. And so that anxiety itself leads to greatest ecstasy when they do come together, when they do finally meet. Then they feel, Krishna feels even greater pleasure.
Which wife of Lord Chaitanya is Radharani herself?
No, we don't say that. Radharani doesn't come as Lord Chaitanya's wife. That's not true.
So she's asking, which wife of Lord Chaitanya?
I said no. No wife comes as Lord. No wife comes as Lord Chaitanya. No, none of Lord Chaitanya's wives are Radharani. Lord Chaitanya himself comes in the mood of Radharani. We say Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. Lord Chaitanya is a combined form of Radha and Krishna.
Krishna Bhakti.
So we said Radha and Krishna are originally one. They separated themselves eternally, but then they became one again in the form of Chaitanya. So Lord Chaitanya comes in the mood of the devotee. He comes in the mood of Radharani. We said Radha Bhava, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mood is Radha Bhava and the emotion of Radharani. Okay. That's an important point to understand. Don't get it wrong. Okay. Any other question?
Final question. And when Radha Bhasi